definition in law of what constitutes a small amount. But there,
if you go now to a coffee shop and you look at the menu, you see 10 kinds of cannabis, Dutch cannabis. That means 10 producers. And most of the times, it's their customers who have green fingers, as we say it in the Netherlands.
There's a lot of people don't smoke dope because it's illegal. You know, they don't want to break the law. They want to, you know, they're quite happy to be law-abiding citizens. So they've got a little bit of a break on them for smoking dope. So I imagine consumption would increase, which means that the demand would go up. Which means that the supply would have to go up, which means there's more criminals at it. So decriminalization actually implies further criminalization in the area that matters, the dealing area, you know? Because one of the big problems about the illegality of cannabis is the money being in the hands of criminals like me.
At the heart of the Green Avalanche is extreme profitability. And we have seen in economic history that if there is profit at such a scale, then there's nothing which can stop the growing of such a crop.
Well, why do they criminalize marijuana but not tobacco? I mean, marijuana anybody can grow in their backyard. It's weed. Tobacco is an industrial product. I mean, tobacco itself isn't harmful. It's the result of the industrial product, the cigarette, that's harmful. And that you can't do in your backyard. That requires capital and technology and so on. So it's controlled. But you let people grow marijuana, everybody can do it for themselves.
I worry about big cigarette companies. The moment cannabis comes legal, are they going to put the crap on the market that they're what they did with tobacco, or are they going to leave us with our nice, beautiful green flowers?
That's why I'm not in favor of legalization, because as soon as it gets, as marijuana gets legalized, all these people with all these dirty hands and all these dirty minds, they'll get their hands on it, you know, and they'll start to produce it and sell it to us and asking us ridiculous prices.
Say, like, you know, Benson and Hedges or something got the monopoly of the country, and they produced shite dope. What had happened? All the dealers and smugglers will still be in business, I reckon. And there'll always be a big black market in dope until the government sells good dope at a cheap price.
I don't need no cocaine, need to mess up my brain. I needed the real thing. Come on, give them the gross. I needed the gross. I needed the real, real, real thing. The real thing. And I'm a sense of me, oh, now me, oh, yeah. And I'm a sense of me, oh, now me, sense. And I'm a sense of me, oh, now me, sense. Whoa, see, whoa, ooh. Hey, Babylon, you don't like ganja, man, but we bring the foreign currency and the island. Hey, Babylon, you don't like ganja, man.
There will be a green avalanche at the European level, which will destroy the wall of prohibition. The politicians will not use their brains, and if they're not using their brains, they will be forced to accept the legalization or the normalization of cannabis, similar to the fall of the Berlin Wall.
The war on cannabis will end, yes, it will be one day, conviction and belief and faith that one day cannabis will be completely legalized in this country. I don't think it'll happen tomorrow, you know. It'll probably be a few years, you know.
Imagine that there is a drug that makes people friendly and mellow and that creates a situation in which they never fight or argue. And imagine that this drug is banned out by society. What does it tell about this society?
Even if they discover that, you know, it causes an epidemic of cannabis psychosis, still safer if it's legalized and controlled than kept illegal.
You can drink a glass of alcohol every day and not much will happen. You can get very old, the French say. But if you smoke a joint every day, you'll gradually become a different person.
Why on earth should smoking something be illegal? Doesn't make any sense.
I always say that the problem with cannabis is the involvement of people who don't smoke it.
Somehow, they don't want to get rid of the drug problems. Because if they want, I'm very sure if they would say, well, we're not going to bother anymore, then there would be much less police work to do, and there would be much less problems, and much less casualties. But, as I told you, they're not going to use their brain.